मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू विद टूडे सेगमेंट स्टूडेंट। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ यू कैरियोटिक सेल। यस स्टूडेंट, यू कैरियोटिक सेल, द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म डेट हैव द यू कैरियोटिक सेल आर नोन एज यू कैरियोट्स। सो वी कैन कैटेगराइज द यू कैरियोट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर किंगडम, मीन्स द एनिमल्स किंगडम, प्लांटी, एनिमेलिया, प्रोटिस्ट, फंजाई। These are the living organism, or these are the group of the living organisms that have the eukaryotic cell. And these living organism that have the eukaryotic cell are known as eukaryotes. What is the main thing that is found in the eukaryotic cell, student? They have the two nucleus, means the definite nucleus is found in them. And as you know that what is nucleus? Nucleus is the control center of the cell. So first, what should you learn? You should learn that eukaryotic cell is found in plantae, animalia, protist and fungi. Now we come the types of the eukaryotic cell. According to the plantae and animalia, student, they have the two type of cell, plant cell and animal cell. Plant cell and animal cell have the different structure. They have the different structure. Their structure is totally different from each other. Now, how is it different? This we will discuss today. Like the plant cell have the two outer covering. Two outer covering is found in the plant cell. First is cell wall and second is plasma membrane or cell membrane, like this. Here are the two outer covering is found, student. First is cell wall. Second is cell membrane. Cell membrane. Now in this, the nucleus is found. As you know that the eukaryotes have the nucleus. So the nucleus is found in them, and that nucleus is found at the side of the cell. So we can draw here the nucleus. This is the nucleus. And what I am making the, these are the nuclear membrane, double membrane nucleus. And it is the nucleolus. It is nucleolus. And what are these? These are the thread-like structure, and what we call them? These are chromosomes. And on the chromosome, these are the granules like structure, and what we call them, they are the gene. And there is a fluid like medium is found, that is known as nucleoplasm. So this nucleus is found at the side of the cell. Now you write here, what is it? It is nucleus. And what is inside the nucleus? It is nucleolus. Now we come on the next. This is found. With this, there are the small tubes like structures are found in the cell. Inside the cell, there are the tubes like structures are found like this. And what are these, student? They are known as endoplasmic reticulum, like this they are found. On some endoplasmic reticulum, there are the granules like structures are found, and these granules like structure are known as ribosome, and in some endoplasmic reticulum they are not found. Now we come on the next important structure that is found inside the plant cell, and it is the large size vacuole, student. This type of large size vacuole, this type of large size vacuole is found. What is it? It is vacuole. With this, there are the other structures are found like this, this structure, and what we call them, these are chloroplast, student. Chloroplast or chromoplast, you can write here chromoplast or leucoplast, they may be. So these are the chloroplast. With this, there are this type of structure is found, this type of structure, and what we call them, we call them lysosome. With this, all these organelles means the membrane bounded parts of the cell are found in a medium, student. They are found in a medium, and that medium is found in both the cell, plant cell and animal cell, and what we call them, cytoplasm. We call it cytoplasm. With this, there are the shoe-like structures are found, students. This type of shoe-like structures are found, and these shoe-like structures are known as mitochondria. What we call mitochondria. With this, these structures are found, parallel vesicles are found, and these parallel vesicles are known as Golgi body, student. And what is the main function of the Golgi body, student? They help in the packaging, and they also help in the metabolism. So these are the Golgi body. So it is the structure. Now, the main structure that is found inside only in the plant cell, that is cell wall. Cell wall is found only in the plant cell, that provides the rigidity to the plant cell. With this, this chloroplast is found. With this, there is a large size vacuole is found, And with this, there are the nucleus is found at the side of the cell. So these are the four main characteristics that are found in the plant cell. Now we come on the next eukaryotic cell, that is animal cell, student. Now we will draw the animal cell, and in the animal cell you can draw this like this. There is only one covering is found in the form of plasma membrane. With this, there is in middle the control center of the cell is found, and that have the double membrane like this, and this control center have the dense body that is known as nucleolus, and that nucleolus is covered by the thread-like structures that are known as chromosome. And on the chromosome, there are the genes are found. So first structure that we have drawn here, it is nucleus. And nucleus is found at the center of the cell in the case of animal cell. Now we draw the tubes-like structure that are found in all over, in whole over the cell, and what we call them in the animal plant cell, we have discussed that these are known as endoplasmic reticulum, and these endoplasmic reticulums is found all around the cell, and what they provide, they provide shape and structure to the cell. Means the animal cell have the particular structure due to the presence of these endoplasmic reticulum. These are endoplasmic reticulum. Now, these endoplasmic reticulum have the two types, student. Like here I am drawing these granules-like structure on them. What are they? They are the ribosome. If the endoplasmic reticulum have the ribosome on them, then what we call them, those endoplasmic reticulum are known as rough endoplasmic reticulum. So they are RER. If they don't have these granules like structure like here, if they don't have, then they are known as SER. With this, around the endoplasmic reticulum, there are the parallel vesicles are found, and these parallel vesicles, so the tubes-like structures, are known as Golgi body, student. These are the Golgi body, and they are discovered by Camillo Golgi. That's why they are known as Golgi body. These are Golgi body. And what is the main function of the Golgi body, student? They help in the packaging. Now, the medium that is found inside the cell and all the organelles and the nucleus is found in it, and this is known as cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is, student, cytoplasm is the site of all the cellular activities. All the cellular activities takes place inside the cytoplasm. And there are these small empty sacs like structures are found, and what we call them? We call them lysosome. With this, there are the hollow sac like structures are found, and these are known as vacuoles. What we call them? These are vacuoles. And vacuole help the cell to collect the food. So we can say them that they are the storage house of the cell. Like this, there is the shoe-like structures are also found. These shoe-like structures are known as mitochondria, student. What we call them? Mitochondria. And mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. And all these organelles or all these parts, we will discuss one by one, student. So today only we will discuss the shape and structure of the plant cell and animal cell and their differentiation. So these are the main structure that are found in this. There are the small sac are also found. Those are known as peroxisome. So these are the structures that are found in the animal cell. With this, there is one important structure is found only in the animal cell, that are centriole, student, centriole. They form the centrosome, and that centrosome help in the cell division, and it is found only and only in the animal cell. These are the parallel vesicles are tightly packed, and these structures, this structure is known as centriole, and it helps in the cell division, and it is found only in the animal cell. It is absent here. So what are the differences that you can write in the plant cell and animal cell, student? The first difference that you can write, cell wall is present in the plant cell, but it is absent in this. In this, it has the rigid shape, but it has in rigid shape, or it has the irregular shape, animal cell. In this, there are the chloroplast or the plastids are found, but in this the plastids are absent. Here the size of vacuole, mean in the plant cell the size of vacuole is large, but in the animal cell it is small. Next difference that you can write, that the centriole are absent in the plant cell, but they are found in the animal cell. Centrioles are present in the animal cell. With this, there is another difference that you can write, that they have, plant cell have the large size vacuole, but the animal cell have the small size vacuole. Now you can tell me, student, that why do the plant cell have the large size vacuole? Tell me. Yes, you are right. Plant cell have the large size vacuole, student, because they don't prepare their food in the night. So to use the food in the night, especially many time they don't get the proper amount of the sunlight, so at that time also they utilize the stored food. That's why the plant cell have the large size vacuole. vacuole than the animal cell. And these are the main differences. All these differences you will learn, and with this you will also learn these label diagrams of plant cell and animal cell that are given in your book, student. Now one by one we will discuss all the parts of the cell in our next segment. So thank you very much and have a nice day.